Would you like to jump right in on learning everything there is to know about inventory in QuickBooks Online? Well then let's do this final setup video together so that after this video we can go straight to the learning. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. The final preparation steps are input example customer list, input example vendor list. We will set up the needed reports, and as a bonus, we will learn how to change the company name and address that prints on the reports and the documents. Please note, however, these will be shown in an abbreviated quick way because it is assumed that most of you know how to do these steps. If not, then you should take the introductory QuickBooks Online course that's available right here on this website. This is only to prepare your QuickBooks Online account for the rest of the course. The next video will be the first actual learning topic, I promise. So let's just get through this. First, we have to put in the customer list. And who do we have? We have Alan Arby, Betty Boop, and Candy Charles. The additional customer information that's besides their name, like address and phone number, would not be relevant to this course. So we want to do the minimum setup so that we can hurry up and start to learn. So you might have learned in a previous course or on your own, to add customers, we click Sales, and then we click Customers. Now that we're in the customer section, this is what you see if it's the very first time that you're coming to the customer list. Click Add Customers Manually, and then you get your first one. I like to put cap locks on. Alan Arby, and save. Now, you're currently in Alan's records. You have to click Customers again to see him as the first one on the list. Then click New Customer, Betty Boop. Then click Save. And again, we're currently in Betty's records. We have to again click Customer to go back to the main list, and now we have two. New Customer, Candy Charles. And of course, click Save. These will be, let's click Customers to see the full list. These will be the three example customers that we work with in this inventory course. Now, what's next? Well, the vendor list. Con Edison, Verizon, Staples, and UPS will be the vendors that give us our normal expenses. Then there's Addie's Orchard and Sam's Farm, and those will be the two vendors that we actually purchase our merchandise from. And again, the additional vendor information is not relevant to this inventory course. So let's go ahead and click Expenses, and then click Vendors. And of course, if it's the first time coming to the vendor window, we will click Add Vendor Manually. Verizon, okay, whatever. Save. Now we're in Verizon's record. We have to again click Vendors and then click New Vendor, and we click Con Edison. That's the electric company here in New York. Click Save. Then again click New Vendor, Staples. We buy our supplies from Staples. Save. And then, of course, the last vendor for expense will be UPS save. And now we'll add our two merchandise vendors the same way. New vendor, Addie's Orchard, save. New vendor, Sam's Farm, and click Save. Now we have our list of vendors on the vendor list, and we're almost finished with the final setup. Now we will set up reports. The best report, no matter what you're learning in QuickBooks, is the trial balance. And we want the trial balance to show the results of all transactions, regardless of date. So this is what we would do. In the left panel, we would click Reports. Now, here are the standard reports, and we will put the ones that we want in the Custom Reports section. So click Standard and scroll down, and let's find the trial balance. You might have to scroll very far down to the Accountant section. It's in the section of For My Accountant, all the way down. Trial balance, click on it. Now, of course, it's empty because we haven't done anything yet. Let's just close the little help. But we want to change this pull down to all dates and then click Run Report. Now the trial balance will show us the results of all transaction regardless of date. Now that it looks the way we want it to look, click Save Customization, and then again we have a choice to change the name, but we won't. Just click Save. And now if you click Reports and click Custom Reports, you'll see the trial balance is here, and all we have to do is go to Custom Reports if we want to find anything. And we can click, and it opens exactly the way we saved it with all dates. Let's again click Reports. Now what's the next report? The profit and loss. Very important to look at when we're studying inventory. So we go to the standard report, reports, standard reports, and profit and loss is actually right here. Let's just click on it. But it only shows year to date. Click the pull down date menu and choose all dates. Now that it's showing the results of all transactions regardless of date, then we will click Save Customization. And again, we could change the name, but let's leave it and just click Save. So now when we click Reports, Custom Report, we have these two reports, and they will help us find everything that we entered, and they will also show us the results of the transactions that we put into QuickBooks Online. What's next? Transaction list by customer and transaction list by vendor. Okay, so they're very easy to find and put in. So we click Reports. In the area of standard reports, just go slowly. Who owes you? Nope, it's not here. It's under the section of sales and customers. Transaction list by customer. Click on it. Make sure that the pull down says all dates, then run report. And now that it shows all the dates, click Save Customization, and then click Save. Let's do the same thing for vendors. Reports, click Standard, go all the way down, go slowly, but go all the way down to the vendor section, expense and vendors, transaction list by vendor. Click on it, and then we change the date pull down to all dates. Run report, and now it says all dates, save customization, and save. What you must be accustomed to is if you're trying to find a transaction that you entered, you can click reports and click the custom report area, and using one of these four reports will help us find anything that we previously entered very quickly and very easily. Now, you may have noticed that I already changed the name to Holden the Fruit Guy, but let me show you how this is done. We will use the account settings, and for some of you, this is called company settings, but it's in the same place, and it does the same thing. And you will learn more about the account settings window in a future video. But for now, let's just do this. Go to the top right and click the cog wheel, then go all the way to the left where it says either account settings or company settings, depending on which version of QuickBooks you signed up for. When you click here, you get the area of defaults and options that control the entire account. And you will notice if you click in the left panel, there are different categories of company settings. The one we will change is this, company, and there are different sections in the company settings. We're changing the company name, so you would have to click this pencil tool, and again, you would have to type in cap locks, Holden the Fruit Guy, because he sells fruit. Click save. See, it changed it. Then click done. And now when you go back to your dashboard, it should say Holden the Fruit Guy, the company that buys and sells fruits. Congratulations, you're all set up and prepared to learn the first education video that follows this one. The topic is non-inventory parts.